Listen, welcome back.
All right.
And fasten your seatbelts. It's going to get weird, especially for Craig.
Keep reading your copy. Oh,
because this morning we're talking about the new competition show, Hyperdrive.
28 races from around the world take on what's being called the biggest, baddest automotive obstacle course ever built. Lindsay Zarniak is here, one of the hosts of the show.
Yeah, we watched the show. Oh, by the way, Lindsay Zarniak also happens to, also happens to be my wife and the racing expert in our house as well.
Oh,
and,
thank you.
And, yeah, well, it's in the prompter.
Oh, I see how you roll.
You recently also had the opportunity to experience a version of Hyperdrive. Here it is.
I'm so excited!
Sweetie, that doesn't look safe.
Wow.
I didn't see that.
I was initially really worried about losing my lunch when I knew I was going to do that. And then they buckle you in like you're a toddler in a car seat and you're so tight. And ACP was the stunt driver. And he's like, everything that we're about to do, your body's going to feel like it's wrong. Wow. But it's going to be awesome. And that was actually the most exhilarating. I know.
What?
Thrill of my life. No, I'm kidding. No, it was just the way it feels. It's like this rush. And honestly, like, so from my perspective, I walked out of there and I said, I know what those people in this competition did was insane, but to feel that and to know that they were driving,
it's amazing. Wow.
And to see it after the fact from a different angle and to see exactly what all you were doing. So in this show, you actually don't go in the cars often. That was kind of a special one.
Never. But I wanted to until I actually did it. Yeah.
What can we see on the show? I mean, I'm thinking Fast and Furious meets some sort of American Ninja Warrior.
Yeah, so, well, I mean, that's the exact way to describe it. And when they said that out of the gate, you know, I had a certain idea. And then when I was there in person, the obstacle course is like the craziest thing that I've ever seen because it is larger than life. They've got this monstrosity called the Leveler that basically cars are driving up. They're trying to balance it. But for me, the cool thing was these competitors, 28 people from all over the world.
So they're just everyday folks?
They're everyday folks.
They've got amazing stories, though.
Yeah, and I would tell you this when we would talk on the phone. I remember a dentist, one of them, Aaron Parker specifically, he was such a great guy, and he raised his siblings, like, in, you know, with a single mom household. Brittany Williams is this superstar woman who... You start to learn that this is a culture all across the United States. The stories these people have, they're just like you and me. And
they make the cars.
They make their own cars.
Oh, really?
If they
break down,
they've got to figure it out. They all band together. But the thing is, it's really all about having a dream and going for it because these people all have side jobs that are legit jobs that they have to do for their lives on the side. And they all gave up time. They gave up money to come and do this for these bragging rights.
Yeah.
And a lot of them are their moms. There was a mom, Corinna Graf, who is from Germany. She and her husband both competed, and their kids were their spotters, right? So that was really cool, too. It was just quite a mix.
It was amazing thinking how cool and calm you were in the car there because when Craig was in the car with Al Roker driving.
Are we doing this? How are we gonna do this?
I mean, he is such a wuss.
It's not true.
Melvin, you know, you're a very kind and steady, steady person, and I think your driving reflects that.
I am a calm and steady driver. It's true.
Kind and steady.
It's true.
Do you remember?
I drive like my personality.
Our first date was in Bertha, his Ford Expedition.
Bertha
was there with us.
No, right.
But I remember that you were, you know, it was steady.
10 and 2.
Part of the woo.
10 and 2.
And Bertha?
I'm not surprised. I guess it all worked out.
Should we, but before we go, the show, it starts streaming today. We watched the first episode last night, and I know, granted, my opinion's biased. Yes. It's a heck of a show.
Are you happy with it, Lindsay?
I think it's awesome. Yeah, and it's awesome. And it's weird that it's been a year, and I recently got to see the competitors, but also it brought me back to when we shot it, which was last July, and I found out that I was part of this 2 days before our family vacation.
She left me with the kids.
I knew that there was no question in my mind I really wanted to do this, but they were in Hilton Head, and I had to say, okay, I'm going to get you there, and then I'm going to go to Rochester for 3 weeks.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
And it was such a great experience. We taped overnights, right? But for 3 weeks, I kept kicking the can on, oh, they're going to come up this weekend and see me, and it just turned into this project that was, like, for me, a real example of, like, work and what you right. want to do yeah. and so that good. Balance and figuring out a way to do it. And you were so great, but it's oh, really cool yeah. to see.
I love well, that. It's probably better that you got to travel there by yourself because Craig apparently leaves you in the back.
We don't have time for this. We don't have time for this.
All I'm going to say is they should have family upgrades.
There you go.
I'm not talking about this here, sweetie. Don't get, sucked into this.
You know what? You're don't sticking around, so we have plenty of time to talk.
There's lots of time.
Hyperdrive.
You're going to help us with the producer challenge.
It starts streaming
yes.
right now on Netflix. Hyperdrive is streaming on Netflix.
It's such an awesome show. So thank you guys. Thanks for letting me talk about this.